Hey everyone, it's Tiffany T here, and you're tuning in to day 13 of Wade and T's 30-day vulnerability challenge. I am extremely late making my video. I've been up all night working and getting stuff done because I'm really making an effort in my life to stick to my commitments and honor that which I say I'm going to do. So, as you know, if you've been following me, I usually record like at the end of my day because then, my day's done and oh, it's easier and better for me to pick a topic to talk about. So, today, or I should have been saying tonight, but it's literally like 5 o'clock in the morning, the sun's coming up. And my mind isn't working properly, so I apologize if I'm tired or whatever. But I wanted to talk about fear versus faith today. And the reason I just wanted to give like a little insight on what I've been seeing personally going on in the world right now, and especially right now with all the things that are happening in our world. And let me back up. First, I want to say thank you so much for tuning in. I really appreciate you, and thanks for watching. And if you have any comments, please feel free to leave them. But there's a lot going on in the world right now, and first and foremost, I just want everybody to know that what I'm about to talk about and what I always generally talk about today and every time that I make a public statement or whatever, it's all just a portrayal of my perceptions, okay? So this is just my come from. It's not, I'm not trying to be harsh or judgmental or anything like that. And I don't know everything. I really don't. The fact is, I know very little in the grand scheme of things, but I'm just only providing like my perspective and my perceptions and my description of what I see and how I see it from my own experience. Okay, so I'm interested also in how you see it as well. So I'm not, please don't take offense. Because I'm so excited to talk about this. Yeah, I'm so freaking tired. But it's something that is real and touchy, and so I just don't want to offend anybody. If I do, I'm sorry, that's on you, because I'm coming from a good place of intentions. So yeah. So to clarify, I'm not saying that I'm right or I'm wrong or whatever. I'm just saying, okay. But what I don't even know really how to put this, but I've been conversing with a lot of all sorts of people from all walks of life, religious, spiritual, not religious, not even having a god or a higher power or whatever. And after there's basically one major underlying dilemma that I'm encountering that are it's kind of like all the same, and that I've noticed, being the keen observer that I am. But there seems to be a power struggle between the like fear and faith factor. So I just wanted to shed some light on the subject real quick for my day 13. And I first off want to state the fact, my facts, real shit here, okay? That like according to yours truly, you can't be in two states of mind at the same time. And today, I really, really want to relate that because it's so dominant right now in society. You can't be in fear and you can't be in faith at the same exact time. So I love the way that Dave Daly puts it, Dave Daly from Monster Motivator TV. He ends all of his shows with himself and the guest he has on his shows, doing the roar. And it's just a way to remind everybody that you cannot be in two states of mind at the same time. You cannot be in gratitude and experience sorrow at the same exact time. You can't be in joy while experiencing devastation at the same time. You can't be in faith if you're experiencing fear at the same time. So I hear many, many people, including myself, I'm completely guilty of this. And I catch myself participating in these behaviors sometimes, and I completely admit it, especially, I mean, I'll be the first to say my own faults and everything. But I hear it a lot, especially with religious people, and yeah, that, you know, God will take care of everything and everything's just gonna work out. But then when the TV turns on and or they read news feeds, or I read news feeds, it's all about like the negativity, drama, chaos going on in the world. And immediately we start to worry, right? It's like human form, human condition. So I go out into the world lately and get educated on what's going on in the real world right now, according from like from different perspectives. And it's predominantly bullshit, like bullshit. No wonder why I'm such a hermit and I don't watch the news. I don't watch TV. I really don't go out. I mean, I socialize and I have a social life and stuff, but the uncertainty of our nation is, I'm baffled, really, really baffled. That's why I wanted to make this video. The uncertainty of our nation with like Donald Trump as our president, and how wrong this is, or how wrong that is, or how, who's doing what, he or she is like doing, who the fuck even cares? I'm just like, whoa. Like I think I've been in a cocoon for a while, because what I've been witnessing is a lot of confusion, a lot of fear, a lot of chaos, a lot of drama. And you know what the crazy thing is? It's all self-inflicted. And I watched Wade's video last night, or actually a few hours ago. It's my last night still. And again, I hear him share his story about what his own encounters are with people living in fear and not having faith or doing anything about making their situations in life better. You know, just staying stuck. And sometimes it takes what it takes. And I know that from experience. I totally know that. But I just want to remind everyone for my day 13 that if we're worried about anything in life, then we're not truly living in the faith that we claim to have. And if we're talking shit on others and pulling others down instead of lifting them up, then we're not living in the faith of our self-esteem. Because we really, if we really had faith, we wouldn't worry, would we? I mean, think about it. If we really had faith, would we worry? If we have true faith in God or whatever, higher power, you believe in whatever it is, we wouldn't worry. And the reason why I say that is because we wouldn't worry about what's going to happen to us or our families in the future. We wouldn't worry how to pay our bills or how to put dinner on the table. We wouldn't worry about if our government is going to confidently make the right and best decisions for the greatest good of all. You know, we wouldn't worry. We just wouldn't worry. Fucking period. So having faith, the definition of faith is putting your complete trust and confidence into something or someone. So if we have real faith in the government and trust that they're doing everything in their power to take care of everything for the greatest good, then we wouldn't have fear. You see, faith and fear, they can't go together. So we are being like hypocrites in some way or another when we do this. And like I said, I'm guilty of it too. So there's no gray area, in my opinion, when it comes to faith. You literally cannot be like, I have faith that God's got my back, but I'm gonna look over my shoulder any way that I can. Anyway, like, that's not faith. That's not faith, people. If we want to live joyful lives that enable us to, what I predominantly hear is to be happy and just enjoy life, enjoy our families, enjoy our loved ones, then we need to wake the fuck up, seriously. And I don't take this lightly because I've seen, and I continue to see firsthand all that's created around me is self-imposed. Now, I can't help what happens in the world, okay? It's not under my control. The only thing I can control is what happens with me. But it's funny because I'm a complete analyzer and I dissect the shit out of everything. And I am an observer naturally, an investigator. And I look inside first and then I look around and I see that this is definitely something that probably we should remind ourselves of every day. Because the reality is that we have the choice to either to live in our misery or live in our highest form of joy. And it's that simple. We have the choice to talk about good things that raise our vibration levels, or we have the choice to talk and gossip about all the bullshit that in turn is bringing us down. So I just wanted to say, like, listen, everyone, listen, 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 okay? Thoughts become things. Thoughts become things. Your words that come out of your mouth are very powerful. Okay, I need to be reminded of this every single day. Trust me, like, it's so easy to forget, and we're here, we're human, we're in our human nature form. But you know what? Stress is a choice. It's such a choice. So, I'm going to share with you an extremely, extremely helpful tip that I learned from the one and only Dino Gomez, my sweetheart. And it's really helped me to, it's helped me immensely to live a more peaceful, serene life with my conscious state of being most of the time harmonious. I'm not saying I'm perfect, and it's not all the time 100% harmonious, of course. There's a balance to everything. But when you find yourself being in a state of worry, you ask yourself a question. So if you're like panicked, stressed out, whatever, you ask yourself, is there anything that I can do personally to change or control the situation? Is there anything I can do to change or control the situation that I'm worrying about? Okay. Is there anything in my control? To make it an outcome that I'm happy with, that I'm content, that I will let go of worrying and doubt and fear and all that stuff, and just be happy. Is there a way? Is there anything I can do? So you have to do self-evaluation. If yes, then get off your fucking ass and do something about it, okay? If no, let me back up. If yes, do something about it. Do anything you can that can be done, okay? If yes, we do need to do everything that we believe we are capable of so that we can move forward and let go of that stress. If not, if you don't have control over it, then you need to let it go. Like, otherwise, you're gonna make yourself miserable, and I know from experience because I've been there and done that, and I still do, okay? Like I said, I'm not perfect. So we need to surrender and move on if there's nothing we can do about it, and stop the bitching and the moaning and the complaining about that which we cannot change. Like, I know It really is as easy as that. However, us in our human form, like I said, we tend to make things so difficult. And I say it's time for us to cut the cord on whatever it is that's holding us back from living a fulfilled, purposeful, joyful, loving, caring, happy, the amazing, beautiful life that we're all supposed to live, that we're all meant to live, that we all deserve to live. That I say we choose to come down here, like, or we, I'm sorry, we chose to come down here at this time to this life, co-creating in this multidimensional reality of existence. And we're so fortunate. We're so fortunate to be living. I mean, really, if you think about it. So I just want to wish everyone a happy Thursday. And please remember that when all is said and done, we are the ones who choose anything for ourselves. So let's choose the good life. Let's choose peace and let's choose harmony instead of chaos and drama and negativity. And if that's what you want, cool. I'm not judging. I'm just saying there's a better way. We're not meant to live in misery. So, okay, I really am so exhausted and I have to go to bed. Oh, but I'm proud of myself because I got everything that is crucial done. So, I love you all. Thank you so much for tuning in. I appreciate you all. I appreciate your comments, your feedback, your likes, your dislikes. Doesn't matter what kind of feedback, I appreciate it all. And if you want to choose with me to purposefully, see, I can't even talk now. Love your life and live it up with me, then do. And until later on in the day, day 14, oh my gosh, almost halfway through. I've weighed and teased 30-day vulnerability challenge. I wish you all the best of everything good in your life, and good night. I'm going to bed. Good day for you, though. All right, take care. Mwah. Love you guys.